गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस द सिलेक्शन प्रोसेस एंड ट्रेनिंग एंड डेवलपमेंट एंड द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ ट्रेनिंग एंड डेवलपमेंट। नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस हाउ ए एम्प्लॉई सिलेक्टेड बाय द एम्प्लॉयर इन ए ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। द फॉलोइंग स्टेप्स आर टेकन टू अकाउंट व्हाइल सिलेक्टिंग ए कैंडिडेट्स बाय द मैनेजमेंट। नंबर वन, प्रिलिमिनरी स्क्रीनिंग। नंबर टू, सिलेक्शन टेस्ट। नंबर थ्री, एम्प्लॉयमेंट इंटरव्यू। नंबर फोर, चेकिंग रेफरेंस एंड बैकग्राउंड। नंबर फाइव, सिलेक्शन डिसीजन। नंबर सिक्स, मेडिकल एग्जामिनेशन। नंबर सेवन, जॉब ऑफर। नंबर एट, एम्प्लॉयमेंट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस वन बाय वन। प्रिलिमिनरी स्क्रीनिंग involves eliminating unqualified or unfit candidates based on the information supplied in application form. Such eliminated candidates are not considered for further steps of selection process. Then number two, selection test. If the organization has a policy to conduct selection test, all the eligible candidates are called for the test. There are various types of selection tests which are used in selection process. Briefly description of some important selection tests is presented at here. Number one, that is your intelligence test. Number two, personality test. Number three, aptitude test. Number four, interest test. And number four, trade test. And also written tests. Intelligence test aims at measuring intelligence level of the candidates. Based on this intelligence test, intelligence quotient is measured by the candidates to know his ability to learn and make decision and judgment in a particular situation. Then personality test. Personality test aims at discovering personality features of the candidates. It predicts performance success of the candidates on job that require dealing with people or job that are essentially supervisory or managerial in character. Then aptitude test. It measures the latent or potential characteristics of the candidates to do something if proper environment and training are provided to them. Interest test discovers the candidate's area of interest and identify the kind of job that will satisfy them more. Then trade test. Trade test is also known as performance or achievement test, aims at measuring the existing level of knowledge and skill of the candidates. And written test, to know the subject knowledge of the candidates. Then employment interview. Employment interview, also known as selection interview, is the most commonly used method of selection. Sometimes the candidates are assessed only on his basis of employment interview. Employment interview is a formal, in-depth conversation conducted to evaluate the acceptability of the candidates. At the same time, the interviewers may share relevant information about the organization. In this stage, both candidate and employer and employees interacting with each other, and the employee also bargain with the employer if selected for the job. Then checking reference and background. Many organizations insist that the candidates provide complete conduct details of the reference from whom information provided by a candidate as verified and additional information about the candidates is sought. This helps in understanding the background of the candidates. Then medical examination. The organization which follow the practice of conducting medical examination, also known as physical examination, or test conducted medical examination at this stage to know about whether the candidate is suffering major diseases or not. The main objective of medical test is whether the candidate is suffering in serious diseases or not. Then selection decision. After the completion of the above steps, final selection of the candidates is made. Normally, selection decision is made by the selection committee consisting of managers of the concerned department and human resource managers. Then job offer. At this step, job offer is made to the selected candidates. The offer is made through the letter of appointment. Sometimes candidates are required to confirm their willingness to join the job. Employment contract. At this step, a contract between the selected candidates and the employing organization is entered. Since this relationship between an organization and the employees is contractual, every new recruit has to enter into a contract with the organization. Contract of employment specify the terms and conditions of the employment. With this step, the selection process for filing positions at a time is over. Then we have to discuss the training and development. Training means the act of increasing the knowledge and skill of an employee doing a particular job. And development refers to learning opportunities designed to help employees' growth or employees grow. Then following are the importance of training and development. Then is economy in operation, higher productivity, reduced supervision, creation of full and skilled personnel, increased employees' morale, and last point is your effective response to environment change. Now we have to discuss one by one the merits of the training and development for the organization. Economy in operation. Trained employees are able to make best possible use of materials and other production related factors like machines, tools, etc., and avoid wastage. This leads to economy in operation. Higher productivity. Trained employees take much lesser time in completing a task, which leads to higher productivity. Reduced supervision. Trained employees require less supervision, and a single supervision supervises a large number of employees. This results in reduced number of supervisors. Creation of a pool of skilled personnel. Training enables an organization to create a pool and skilled personnel. These personnel may move to higher positions whenever the need arises. Increase employees' morale. Training raises employees' morale, which not only reduce absenteeism and turnover, but development favorable attitude towards the organization. Then effective response to environmental changes. Business environment changes continuously. Trained employees react to these changes quickly as they have higher adaptability. And now we have to discuss also the benefits of training to the employees. Benefits of training to the employees are as follows. Number one, better career prospects, increased earning, reduced accidents, versatile use, and increased satisfaction. Better career prospects. Training leads to develop skill and knowledge in employees. Because of this, they have better career prospects and move upward. Increased earning. Training leads to increased productivity, hence increased earning is most of the organization link productivity and earnings. Reduced accident. Trained employees handle various equipments more systematically and carefully, which result in reduced accidents or even no accidents. Versatile use. Trained employees may perform alternative jobs with equal efficiency. Thus, during the retrenchment due to recession, these employees are spared. Increased satisfaction. Training leads to increased satisfaction among employees due to better performance, which itself is a source of satisfaction. This is about the merits and demerits of the merits of training and development. And next period, we have to discuss the types of training provided to the employees. That is on the job and off the job, and its merits and demerits, and different types of on the job and off the job training. Thank you. Have a nice day.